hi-de-ho there again, boys and girls, and welcome to yet another edition of Live from the Tape Farm. And we're back with the Firefly FFDCS to talk about some of the changes we're going to make to this guy today. So one of the things we're going to do is we are going to pot this pickup. So an issue I had with this guitar is any sort of decent gain or pedal or plugging it into an amp and getting anywhere near the amp, you'd start getting a lot of squealing from the microphonic properties of the pickup. Now, while playing it, I like the sound of the pickup. It's got a, you know, it's good sounding pickup. Just could do without that squealing. So one of the comments in the first video, I made a video, first part of this video, where we did kind of unboxing, fit and finish, things like that, pointed out the microphonicness of the pickup. I remember like it was just yesterday. All right, guys, so you're gonna hear a little bit of buzz in the background. So I got a little bit of delay on the guitar. So we're gonna check, are these pickups microphonic? Or this pickup microphonic? Hey! Yeah, it is. Quite a bit, actually. So it is pretty pretty microphonic. Hey! So after we pop this pickup, we are going to see if we've improved in its microphonicness. We're going to see if we've improved that making it amp-friendly sort of thing where we can get up close to an amp and get the fun feedback that we all love. Without getting the squealing and screeching that we don't really love. So today, that's what we're going to be doing. We're going to be potting this pickup, so let's get to it. Alrighty, so what we're going to do here is we're going to boil some water. And I got this little pot at like a local bargain store. And it fits in there just perfectly. We don't want the wax in the pot directly. Boil the water, kind of a double boiler kind of setup. We melt the wax in this pot. So we're going to start boiling and we'll see what happens. Now, everything I've heard says the wax should be somewhere around 150 degrees. You don't want any more than that. Paraffin is flammable. Obviously, they make candles out of it. So you don't want the wax to, if the paraffin starts to smoke, it's too hot. So we just want it melted. We don't want it smoking. All right, so everything I've read online about this is you're supposed to use a combination of paraffin wax, which is this Gulf wax right here, paraffin, and beeswax. So we're going to go ahead and try that combination. I've read usually anywhere between a 80-20 mix, 80% paraffin to 20% beeswax. So I'm going to go a little higher with the beeswax just because it works out to be about, I think with the as much wax as I have here, it comes out to be about 27% beeswax to and the rest is paraffin, so 7% I'm not going to worry about. But also, I've also heard that it doesn't really make all that much difference one way or the other. I've heard people just use straight paraffin, and it works just fine. So I'll try this and see how it works, and then we'll go from there. I mentioned earlier that we're going to let the water boil. Probably not going to let it boil, because then the wax will get too hot. So we're going to regulate the temperature, but we're going to get this to the point that it's starting to melt, and then we'll throw in the paraffin. And so let's start the crazy time lapse. We'll be right back. Bingo. Close enough. 152 degrees. I'll take it. All right, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to try to lower this guy into the wax as evenly as possible. Got this little rig above my on my stove here. Hopefully this works. And into the wax she goes. And we just let it sit there for 10 to 15 minutes from everything I've read and seen. And basically what you're doing is you're just waiting for it to stop bubbling. You can see little bubbles popping up there. And what we want is for that bubbling to stop, and eventually the wax will heat up the pickup. You see where it's gotten cloudy right on the middle of the pickup there, and you see it's slowly shrinking. So that's the wax hardening on the cold metal, and then as the metal heats up, it'll become liquid again and start seeping into the pickup. So now we're just going to let that go. Just so you know, from this point, from the beginning, from when I started putting wax in the water to now, it's been about 40 minutes. So this isn't, you know, like a quick and easy like thing to do, but, you know, I guess 40 minutes isn't a whole lot of time, but I just didn't want you to think, oh my God, that only took 10 minutes. No, it took 40. So just so you know, getting the temperature where we need it to be. So let's let that bubble and we'll see what happens here in a little bit. Our 15 minute timer has gone off. Now we're just gonna stare at it for a couple of seconds and see if there's any more bubbles coming up out of there. So I think we're done. So now what we're gonna do is we'll just raise it and let it drip its excess wax back into the pan. We'll just let that hang there for a little bit and let that turn off the heat. Let that wax drip off, and the stuff in the pan will eventually solidify. And then what we'll do is I'm thinking what I'll be able to do is I'll just be able to pull that, you know, cut that thread and then just pull it through. And it won't, you know, it won't leave any harm behind. Worst case scenario, if I can't pull it through, I just cut it really short and there's a little tiny piece of thread in there. No big deal. Then after everything solidifies on the pickup, then, you know, on the top edge, anything, any wax that's still on the plastic, you know, we'll just rub that off. And that should be it. And then we'll put it back in and we'll see what happens. All right, guys, so we're going to do the same test we did in the first video where we tested the microphonicness of this pickup. So we're going to run that same test now with this guy. Same amp, same delay. So everything is exactly the same. Same setting, same volume. Everything's exactly the same. So let's see what we got. Hey! Tiny bit. Hey! but nowhere near what it was before. It is greatly improved. Greatly improved. So let's see what she sounds like. So what I'm going to do here is we're going to play the demo from the first video, which you should go back and look at that just so you can see where we're at. But basically the first half of the video you'll see now will be the pickup in its stock configuration. And the second half of the video will be the potted pickup. What we're looking for here is to make sure we didn't drastically change the sound of the pickup. So let's see what she sounds like. Well, so there you have it, boys and girls, the Firefly FFDCS. God, I wish they would come up with a better name for this guitar. the P90 pickup, we potted it, wax potted it, and made a huge difference in the feedback control, that squeal control, which is really what we were looking for. And it really didn't change the characteristics of the pickup. Listening to the demo, the little video there, I think the only thing that was a little bit different in the stock configuration is the pick scrape. And that's just because I probably just did a crappy pick scrape on the second take. I mean, the pickup still sounds really good. Very rock and roll. In the first video, I mentioned the guitar that is primarily on the right side. It had a pedal on it with like a little bit of fuzz. And when I did the initial recording, I still had a really hard time keeping that feedback and that squeal under control when I was cutting the initial stock configuration tracks. I had to put a pretty hefty noise gate on it in order to control it. But I was able to just completely remove the noise gate. Same amp, same settings, everything exactly the same, just removed the noise gate and didn't have any problems whatsoever. So this is definitely worth the time and the effort to do it. And man, it's not hard and it's not expensive. The wax, I think, cost me $10. And look at this. I still got a big whole honking pot of wax. So, I mean, whenever I need to pot another pickup, if I ever need to do it again, just throw this on the stove in the double boiler, let it melt, wax my next pickup, so on and so forth. This will probably last me 10 years. What I want to do is I'll want to put this in a bag and seal it up so no dust gets in it. So a really easy mod and definitely greatly improved the amp friendliness of this guitar. So that's all I got for you tonight, today, whenever you happen to be watching this. I appreciate you guys watching and we'll catch you later.
Hey folks, thanks for watching. The Tape Farm specializes in analog to digital transfers of many prosumer tape formats. From standard cassettes up to 16-channel multi-track recordings, we specialize in formats from manufacturers like Tascam, Fostex, Alesis, and others. So if you have some old tapes in your closet that you'd like to get converted to digital files that can be loaded into your DAW of choice to either relive or remix the past, send them on to us. You can check us out at thetapefarm.com.